Hello everyone, welcome to the newest iHilton video. Today, we're going to be doing something so exciting. We're going to be talking about today's Apple event, actually called Apple Event October 18th. It doesn't actually have a name. So, first, before we start, be sure to like, subscribe, comment down below if you're excited for this video, and yeah, let's get right into it. Okay, so first, we're going to talk about AirPods. So I am so excited because AirPods haven't gotten a refresh in a very long time, except for those AirPods Maxes, which people were actually upset about because they were so expensive. I was too. But let's get right into it. So these new AirPods are an add-on to the normal AirPods, not AirPods Pro, and they're called AirPods 3. They have an all-new design. They're sweat and water resistant. It has improved quality for FaceTime calls, spatial audio, really cool, so excited, and new Apple custom driver, longer battery life, personal engraving, announced notifications with Siri, force sensor controls, guys. So this has been brought down from their, I guess you could say, parent AirPods Pro, and brought down to the lower end model, well, not so lower end anymore, AirPods. Dolby Atmos support for Apple Music, Find My network. I'm so excited, especially with WatchOS 8. It'll tell you if you left your AirPods behind, which is really helpful. It does support MagSafe charging, which is so, so exciting. I don't have a MagSafe charger, and I'm not planning on getting these AirPods, but I'm just so excited for the people that do, because MagSafe is amazing. Adaptive EQ, which is like, it moves around with where you're moving and your ears, depending on your ears. So, because not everyone has the same ears, of course. And yes, something that they didn't actually mention in the video, and it's not that major, but it does have a new light for if it's not fully charged. It's a little brighter. And there is faster, their chip is faster inside the AirPods, so that when you're pairing them to your iPhone, iPad, Mac, or anything in the Apple ecosystem, they start at $179, and they will be shipping today. You can order them today, and they'll be shipping next week. Okay, now, the moment you guys have been waiting for, MacBook. So, Mac just got a huge refresh. So, this new Mac refresh, it's about the MacBook Pro. So, we have two new chips. The first chip is called M1 Pro, and the second chip is actually called M1 Max. So, M1 Pro has a ton of really amazing stuff. It is many times faster than M1, in some cases up to 3 times faster, and in some up to 5. It has a 70% faster GPU performance than M1, CPU, rather. And this computer just amazes me. It has 200 megabyte per second download speeds from Wi-Fi, stuff like that. And it's just very amazing to me. So now let's talk about M1 Max, and then we can talk about the redesign. So the M1 Max has most of the same features, but this graph that you guys are seeing right now is just amazing. So it is actually, the power consumption in watts is 30, it's only 30, with a 32 core MacBook. But the leading 8-core PC laptop chip, 8-core, you guys, takes up a little over 60 watts. That's just amazing. So you're with M1 Pro and M1 Max, you're getting less watts, which saves on battery, so that you can do more stuff without needing to plug in your MacBook. So, and it's also many times faster. It's 4 times faster, while still taking up less power. So M1 Max is actually, let's look at this. This other graph that you guys are seeing right now, high-end PC laptop graphics, this one takes up 160 watts. And M1 Max takes up only 50 at about the same level of power. So that's amazing. Some really quick facts is 10-core GPU, 32-core GPU, or 10-core CPU, 32-core GPU, sorry, up to 64 gigabytes unified memory, support for 4 external displays, secure enclave. Really, I love Apple security. Thunderbolt 4, ProRes encode and decode, 57 billion transistors, 16-core neural engine, and 11 trillion operations per second, industry-leading performance per watt, 5-nanometer processor, 400 gigabytes per second memory bandwidth, and much more. These two new chips just blow me away. They're so amazing. So now let's talk about MacBook Pro. MacBook Pro is amazing. I really, really love this redesign, and I am so ready for it. I feel like we really needed a redesign with more ports. So this new redesign has two models, a 16-inch model, and you guessed it, a 14-inch model. So both of these models actually have support for both of the new chips, aka M1 Pro and M1 Max. So these two new computers actually have MagSafe. This is called MagSafe 3. It will not work with MagSafe 1 or 2 because they redesigned the shape so that you have to buy it. But it still does charge via USB-C from one of their three amazing USB-C ports. Two next to the MagSafe side and one next to the HDMI and SD card slot. I'm so excited for this SD card and HDMI, even though I will definitely not be getting this computer. I'm just super, super excited for these new changes. And yes, it still does have a headphone jack. This headphone jack is a lot faster, which sounds really weird, but it is a lot faster, and it has better support for audio. It also has a brand new cooling system with two fans instead of one or maybe even zero if you have M1 MacBook Air. So, as you can see, there's a diagram of how the heat is pushed in and out. I am looking at it, and it kind of looks like the 2015 MacBook Pro, and that MacBook Pro had really good thermals, so I'm so excited. And this new computer, both of these new computers, have amazing weight and thickness. The new 16-inch model is only 4.7 pounds, fitting right into your backpack, and at only 16.8 millimeters thin. Meanwhile, the M1 MacBook Pro, including M1 Pro and M1 Max, is 3.5 pounds thin, almost as much as a 3.5 pounds, 3.5 pounds heavy. So this MacBook Pro is almost as light as the MacBook Air, which is so exciting with all that power. And it is only 15.5 millimeters thin. So the keyboard was also redesigned, and I'm just so excited for this new keyboard design. They took the standalone Magic Keyboard with Touch ID and put it into the MacBook. So they got rid of the touch bar finally, and put clickety-clackety keys for the menu bar, and they are perfect squares actually. Now noticing that now, I'm just so excited for this. And know that white box is not around the real thing. There's also that Touch ID sensor looking really nice. And as you can see on the screen, the bezels on the top are 60% thinner. And look at that notch. There is now a notch on the MacBook. So in probably as soon as you guys watch this video, you guys will be like, oh, Apple get rid of the notch. But it'll be an iPhone all over again. But this notch is actually really, really small. But 60% thinner bezels on the top is amazing, and they pushed the menu bar up so that you have more screen real estate. The menu bar does not come further down than the camera, so that takes up no screen space for the menu bar at all. And you guys can actually see how thin the screen is from here, and you can see just what they had to do. They have the blue pixels, then they have all these sheets. I forgot what these are called. And then finally the finished product, which is what you see. So, and yes, they are a little bit late to this trend, but there is 1080p on their FaceTime camera now. So now we can finally say HD camera. This is so exciting with a new four element lens. I'm just super excited and thrilled that Apple has finally done this. Some other things are computational audio, ML-based noise reduction, ML-based face detecting, which helps with skin tone and stuff like that, local tone mapping, auto white balance, auto exposure, and smart HDR. So this picture might be a little overwhelming, but I assure you it's not. It's just showing the studio quality 3-meg array, which we have had, but this one's updated. It's a little different to fit. As you can see, these are the subwoofers, I'm pretty sure. These are the two speakers. And then, as you can see in this picture, there are four. You see these ones highlighted in blue? Actually, underneath them, there's one more underneath each of them. So there are actually six speakers now. These can push air up to six, disperse air up to 80%. It can impact air up to 80% more than any other MacBook that they've made, which is so exciting. And sorry about that helicopter in the background every time I film a video. And this picture is CPU performance. So M1 Max in the MacBook Pro 16-inch is 2 times faster than the Core i9 MacBook Pro 16-inch. Same with M1 Pro. And yes, these are the most powerful Mac notebooks ever, with up to 7 hours additional video playback on the 14-inch model, and aka 17 hours video playback, which is so amazing. So that's a lot of shows if you guys are binging Squid Game. So you also have 21 hours, 21, that's almost a full day of video playback on the 16-inch model. That's just amazing. I can only imagine what the standby time is. They didn't actually mention that in the video. So I'm sure MKBHD will do something like that, or LTT. 100% recycled aluminum, which is amazing for the environment, so that they're not creating any new metal for this new MacBook. There's no mercury, no PVO, no berylium, no BPR, which is BFR, sorry, which is kind of like the stuff that says BPR free on water bottles. 100% recycled tin. More than 110 suppliers committed to 100% renewable energy for Apple. Zero waste. And we will be 100% carbon neutral by 2030, which is coming up. 100% virgin wood fiber from responsibly managed forests. 100% recycled rare earth materials in all of their magnets, which is really great. Display glass free of arsenic. And recycled plastic used in multiple components, including the speakers. It does have an Energy Star, which is really, really amazing, which basically means it's approved energy efficient by the US government. And it has 90% or more fiber-based packaging. So that's the new MacBooks. These are just a lot of really great pictures and really a really great MacBook in general. So they're a quick recap, up to 21 hours of battery life, up to 2 times faster storage, up to 11 times faster ML, up to 3.7 times faster GPU, 6 speaker sound system with spatial audio, up to 13 times faster graphics, and advanced thermal architecture, and a ton more. You can pause this and read it if you would like. And this is the M1 family. This is the little baby and the huge powerhouses. So this is the new Apple Silicon lineup. We will be keeping all of the M1 Max, but that's it so far, and I am here for it. Now let's head on over to HomePod Mini. Okay, everyone. HomePod Mini is now in color. So some of you guys may know that HomePod Mini is only in black and white right now, but now let me show you all these colors. They are in white, navy blue, this beautiful orange, red, and yellow, which I really like, and of course black, so they still have the original colors. But I am so excited for this. We just have a ton of new things for HomePod Mini. Super excited. And it is basically the same, not gonna lie. It does have some new Apple Music features, but we'll save those for a new video because that would take a long time. But one of them is actually a new subscription plan. Well, everyone, this video is finished, and I would just like to thank all of you guys for watching and pressing the thumbs up button. You also should have subscribed by now, no kidding. But if you would like to subscribe, please do. It really helps us out. And if you would like us to work on our website so that you guys can get tech support, please comment down below and like this video because it really helps out the algorithm so that we can pay for our domain. So thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment down below. And we'll see you in the next iHealth video. Goodbye.